Alrighty, welcome everybody to the first round of our Pauper League video. And let's see, we have one land, but we do have Birchlore Rangers, which allows us to generate mana, especially with Nettle Sentinel and Quarian Ranger. One cool thing about the Quarian Ranger is if you, you know, do miss your land drop, you can return to forest and replay it and use that kind of as a pseudo mana source. So I'm gonna keep this hand. Not sure what I'm going to lead with, though. Probably the Nettle Sentinel, as it just attacks. Because we can play the Nettle Sentinel, attack for two, then play like a Birchlore Rangers and like a million creatures next turn. Jungle Hollow into Swamp into Grizzly Salvage. Okay, well, I don't have any graveyard stuff. Viscera Dragger, Wild Mongrel. I have never played against this deck. But it looks like it could be sweet. Some unearth shenanigans. So first things first, let's attack. We don't have Crater Hoof Behemoth in our deck, as it is a Pauper deck. All right, so let's go ahead and play the Birchlore Rangers. I'm gonna auto yield to this. I guess if I led with Quarian Ranger, I could have gone turn to Elvish Vanguard, but I wouldn't have been able to play anything else. Also, I wouldn't have been able to get in for two. All right, so we can play out a bunch of our one drops, which isn't great with our Elvish Vanguards, but... Oh, actually, hold on. So we play the Quarian Ranger. Oh, yeah, this actually works. See, I'm still learning how to play this deck. So we're missing a land drop, but we get to, since we haven't played a land, we can just tap these two for green. Then we can, let's just untap the Quarian Ranger and return the forest, play the forest. Then now we can play the Elvish Vanguard. Boom. So now we can tap these two for green, play another one drop. Do that. Oh yeah, this, look at this. Doesn't this seem like we're playing like some other format? Wow. So we've already made our land drop for the turn, but if we untap one of our elves, we can actually play the other Elvish Vanguard, so I might as well do that. Green. Wow. I really hope my opponent doesn't have some kind of crazy sweeper. It's very possible that I could have somehow played this earlier or played the Well-Wisher, but I think that was still a pretty good turn for us. All off of one land. Hooting Mandrills. And killed our Nettle. I'm surprised my opponent killed the Nettle Sentinel and not the Elvish Vanguard. Alright. So I think I'm just going to attack with the Elvish Vanguard here. Let's go ahead and just play a Well-Wisher. Always yield. Whoops. Green. And we can, I guess we can attack for six and then just like untap it. Return a forest. Oh wait, I didn't need to, punt. My bad. I forgot that I had no I forgot that I had no lands in play at the beginning of that turn. Like, it's not gonna matter too much, but it's just, yeah. Alright. We managed to overwhelm the opponent on green black, some kind of green black graveyard deck. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I have no idea what my opponent's trying to do. I can't imagine Essence Warden being that great. Verdant Longbow probably isn't great either. Neither is Gleeful Sabotage. Or Tangle, for that matter. They could have some removal. They could have Nausea. I could see that. So Spider Silk Armor could be good. It looks like we're likely the aggressor, but no, you know what? They also had like cards like Wild Mongrel, so maybe just like Well-Wisher is pretty good too. I imagine Green-Black doesn't have a whole lot of flyers. It's actually possible that we just shouldn't sideboard at all. Just based on what we saw. Outside, except for maybe the Spider Silk Armors. Like, Nausea is the only card I can think of that would be very good against us. So maybe we do that. Probably take out some of the twos. Something like that. I think Well-Wisher's pretty good if they're trying to beat us down, but this is just a classic case of not exactly sure what I'm supposed to be sideboarding. Like, the original list that I played had two Elvish Visionaries, and the only matchups where I really, really want four are, like, the control matchups. Which, I'm still not sure if this is a control matchup or not. Alright. Very similar draw to the last game. Let's attack. I don't think my opponent has this figure, or they would have attacked. All right, so once again, Birchlore Rangers. Green, Quirion Ranger. Green. Wait, you have a removal spell now? Although it's not really going to matter here. If my opponent kills my Quirion Ranger, so be it. The real question for me is whether or not I want to play like an Elvish Vanguard or the Sylvan Ranger. Probably just the Elvish Vanguard. Yeah, I can't play anything else. I only have access to 1.5 mana. Wow. That's not the ideal turn for my opponent, I don't think. Main phase, huh? All right, so that's a Lissalana Huntmaster. Well, how much mana do we have access to? So we can go like 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Then we can untap a creature and play the Huntmaster. Let's see, what I can do is tap these two Elves for mana. Then tap this for mana, that's two mana. Then return to the forest and untap an elf. I don't know if that's actually great though. Like, do I want the Huntmaster, or do I just want to like put a bunch of stuff on the board? Like, it might be better just to like play an Elvish Vanguard and go off that way. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. So tap those. Sure, and the land. Let's play Elvish Vanguard. Because I don't really need the Sylvan Ranger with the Quirion Ranger in play. Alright. Green, green. Then we can now use this to untap a creature, return to forest, play the land. One, two, three. One, two, three. So we have three mana. So we can play a Timberwatch Elf or a Sylvan Ranger. Timberwatch Elf seems better. And yeah, we can't play anything else. All right. Yeah, I mean, like, Nausea doesn't even really do it here, right? I can't imagine there's, like, a good common sweeper for three mana. Like, Nausea kills two of my creatures? But I still have a 3-3 or 2, yeah. Yeah, this figure's not quite going to get it done here. Although that was not bad. Let's see, we go Sylvan Ranger into land. Land into nothing. Oh. Oh my goodness, I know what my opponent's doing and it's not going to be good. I think my opponent's going to discard a bunch of cards to put a Hooting Mandrills into play. But that doesn't really do a whole lot. Yeah, I mean, this is the type of matchup that is just so, so good for us. Let's always yield to this one too. And do that. Wait, might as well untap that one. And play another elf. I think we should just get a blue source just in case my opponent kills my Birchlore Rangers. Oh wait, no, I'm a silly goose. I don't know why I did that, actually. See, this is the inexperience with the deck. I probably should have yeah, I'm so used to this generating mana. Like, I obviously should have just I could have used that to activate Timberwatch Elf twice, which would have been way better. But I mean, my opponent has one card in hand, like, I think they're still just dead. They have to block both of these creatures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, if two Timberwatch activations was lethal, so this was a punt. I guess it didn't matter. All right, well, there you have it. Yeah, I should have used that Timberwatch Elf twice. It's okay. It's okay, we're learning. Learning is important in Magic.